Hello guys, welcome. It's Ryan here for the London Craftsman channel. How's it all going? And in today's episode, I'm going to be talking about my business, the London Craftsman, and how I got to where I am now in my workshop, which I am working in right now. So I'm going to be just starting from the beginning. I'm going to be just talking about my background, what I did when I left school, my apprenticeship, what companies I went to, when I started my first workshop, how I did my second workshop, and ultimately my third workshop, which I am in now. It's a little bit more about the second workshop because 5 years ago, I did leave that one, but it was my dad's old garage and that is now closed down. So I took a good old 10-minute video and it's a bit of an insight really of how I got to where I am now. So it's well worth a watch, a little bit of information. So if you are starting up yourself or you are interested, well worth a watch. So anyway, gonna flick through a few photos, talk through them. And after a couple of minutes, that video is gonna start of my middle workshop, let's call it, where the London Craftsman officially started from. So enjoy the video, watch to the end, and I hope you enjoy. Okay, so let's start from the beginning. In 1998, I left school. I was around 16 years old, and I went straight to an apprenticeship in Higginson's, a stair-making factory in Colindale, London, and I was there from 1998 to 2000. I left early, because the money was so poor, sort of like 20 or 30 quid a week. And I felt like I could move on and do something else. So from there, I moved to King's Cross Joinery. So from 2000 to 2001, then I was 18 years old to 19 years old. I went there for a year to make sash windows, box frames, doors, anything timber, which was really, really eye-opening. So from 2001 to 2007, I went to a place called Haymills. And it was in Wembley, Third Way, around the edge of the old Wembley Stadium, or the new Wembley Stadium. And I learned tons there. It was a joinery company, absolutely huge, just as big as the second workshop. So when you watch the video of the second workshop coming up in a couple of minutes, you'll see the scale and the size of it. And I learned tons. I made things from bars, desks, counters, one-off bespoke pieces, learned how to do radius work, edging, lipping, veneers, tons and tons. And I had an amazing foreman which taught me the correct way of doing all of this. He had loads of patience with me and I blossomed in that company. Unfortunately, it closed down. Otherwise, I would have been there forever. So from 2007, let's just say early 2008, I was forced to start my own business. Basically, I put an ad in Gumtree and I got one job from it. And from that point, I was like, where am I going to work? My dad was a mechanic at that point. He has been all his life. And he let me use his lockup. So if you see in the photos, it was a long row of garages. He let me have a single garage right at the end or a single lockup. And that is where my joinery company or my business started without me knowing. So that was in 2008, which is, what was that, 14 years ago? And I call myself Cooper's Carpentry back then. And I was there from 2007 to about 2009. Done a few big jobs there. And then my dad got kicked out. They wanted to build houses on that stretch. So he ended up looking for somewhere else. And he found a massive, massive warehouse, which he divided into two garages. Him, which was Hendon Service Centre, and another garage, M&Y Autos. It was huge. He let me have a big corner of it, which this video is generally about. You're going to see this soon, just after this. It's all about this part of my business and this time of my life, where this workshop started and how big it was and how I built it, etc., etc. So I was there from 2009 up until about mid-2014, when he had bad luck and the landlord wanted to knock it down for houses once again. So everything is sort of going against us here, but you know, in the long run, it's got me to where I am right now, because I'm in the workshop where you see all my YouTube videos. It's at the perfect stage. I've got the perfect workshop for me and the spray room, and it works perfectly. And I've been there since 2014 up until now, and I love it in my new workshop. But I do owe it to my past, and especially the workshop before, my dad's old garage. And I want to say a massive thank you to my dad, because he's made my past possible. Everything where I, what I'm doing right now, I owe to my dad. Let me use his single garage, then let me have a whole corner of his workshop rent free, which is absolutely amazing. So basically this video is all about this part of the workshop, and I'm showing you how I worked, showing you my workshop. The old school workshop is a bit dilapidated now, but it was gonna get knocked down the day after. I had to make a video in honor of it. So here it is, I'm gonna let it play. Enjoy the video. So here it is. This is the place that I spent so long in. This was the second workshop that Joe and I built. We built the whole structure out of reclaimed timber. Everything that you see here was all reclaimed 2x4x2s and a bit of steel work. And it just brings it all back. Look at the old roof all falling apart. But we've been out of here for 7 years now, and as you know, we're in the new workshop and spray room that you see now in our recent YouTube videos. We've been there 7 years. But as this was my dad's garage, there he is. He's the one who made it happen. He's moving out now, and have a look at it. Like, this is the big space, huge. My dad's a mechanic, and used to be an oven there. Used to be a couple of lifts here for cars. That's his office there, shared office, two garages there. My dad's office was there. And he was kind enough to let me have this whole entire space, which was about, off the top of my head, it's probably 5 meters wide, 9 meters further back. Because he gave us that floor space, me being me, thought, well, we've got all that space up there, let's utilize it. So I'll go up there and I'll show you what we used to have. Again, it's this roof has been leaking for some while now. We always had problems with the roof. So it's falling apart. It's been leaking and leaking and leaking for years and years. And this is why down at the bottom it's dilapidated. So we built a rack there, never really got used. Because this garage is going now, we've just been sorting through stuff and all this stuff is going. But we've got all our old joinery bits and pieces, one of our first bits that we did, a nice oak bed that we made. Old template, see, back in the day I used to do some nice joinery. We used to make panels out of solid wood, so that was a template that we made. Yeah. Brings it all back. It's all gonna go now. Loads of jigs and stuff there. A little tread jig. But yeah, up here was the rack, and there was for small offcuts, and we had all our tools stored here, and we built a table on this side. And this was gonna be our office space, or maybe we're gonna do some light work up here, non-dusty work. But the two extractors that we had, well, we have now that I'm actually trying to sell, used to live here. So the dusty extractors were at the top, and then there was a hole down that the hose went down to the bottom to the machines that we needed. And there's also a hatch here. Where are you, hatch? Oh, there's somewhere under there. It lifted up, so we can talk to each other and pass materials through without, you know, if we had a whole sheet or half sheet that we wanted to pass down to some timber, we could just come up and pass it through the hole. Also have a hatch here. Can you see that hatch? That was so we can pass up full sheets of MDF and store them up here too, because space was tight back then. As you can see, we utilized all of this space here because it was hard to use, like as in working. So that was the rack and all the storage for our tools. And this was gonna be our little office. So little bits and pieces that we're just chucking and not using anymore. Old laminate. Yeah, it's all going. So much material went into this. It's a shame I can't take it all down and reuse it, upcycle it somehow, but I'm sure the builders will end up knocking it down. It will go in a skip. Yep, right, let's go back down. This was the sketchy stairs that we had to go up and down. Do it one-handed now. fallen down that a few times. Oh, so what I was telling you about the extraction, you can see the way it came down. And hopefully I would have put some pictures up of the machines. This used to be lovely and clean. It used to have nice, freshly grey painted floors. It was nice and bright. Had our planer thicknesser in here, our table saw, a couple of benches. That's the hatch I was talking about. That was quite cool. Ah, oh, brings it all back. Racks for our sash clamps. This wasn't here, see? As soon as I left 7 years ago and moved into the new place, they tried to use the space again, and then they just knocked the wall down, put a steel in there just to have it to spray in here and use for mechanics, because ultimately this was a mechanics warehouse and a spray room. So they got the space back. But yeah, I was in here for about 7 years ago, for probably 2 or 3 years. And my dad's been here since 2010. Yeah, he's been here since 2010. I probably came with him around 2010. Before that, I was in a little lockup. My dad used to be a mechanic in another place in Finchley. And that was a small double garage size. He let me use that. So I was basically Cooper's carpentry back then for a year or two. So when I got laid off when I was in my 20s, something like that, my dad kindly lent me a bit of space there as well. So they started Cooper's carpentry there. Was there for a couple of years, and then my dad's, they were knocking that down as well to build houses. So he rented this place out, let me have this. And it's just gone from, you know, it's gone up in stages to where we are now. And it's mad when you look back, the timeline, how it's all, you know, it's how it's all meant to be. It's all fate, isn't it, at the end of the day? So yeah, sad to see it go, but new era. My dad's still not sure what he's gonna be doing in the future. He doesn't really want to be doing mechanics anymore. Cold, dirty, and he's done it all for all his life, and I think it's time that he just relaxes and chills out. He's done enough work for his life. He'd just retire nicely. That would be nice. So I think today is the last day. They're coming to knock this whole place down tomorrow, and let's give you a little tour quickly before we go. But firstly, this is my dad's office. I was always in here. We didn't use the office up there, did we, Dad? We're always in here. My dad, I think he used to get a bit, he is a very patient person, but you remember all the planer thicknesses going off?
Yeah, the noise.
Yeah, the noise. And constantly in here, because that was the side. But this, we had a nice sofa here, leather sofa. His computer was here, so he used to go on there and play games and had the heater on. It was lovely and warm in here. And it's sad to see it all go. I remember helping my dad build this. So me and Joe, Joe was partners with me for a couple of years. He came and partnered in my business, the London Craftsman. And we actually built that section. It's a mezzanine steel frame, but we helped my dad kit it out and make it the office that it is. And that's all staying. But getting sidetracked here. So there the offices, skanky, typical toilets. Don't know why I'm showing you in here, but yeah. And this is where all the tools were. Again, look at all the waste. Crap, mechanics, like, how do you even know what that comes off? Even if they're brand new, I mean, how would you know what part that came off and how to reuse it? You don't, it just gets skipped. Tea room over here. Microwave, oven, sink, etc., etc. Compressors used to live in there. A couple of big old compressors. Engine parts wash. Some big fat compressors that supplied us as well for our air tools. Yeah, there was a big oven here. You can see all those just took up this whole entire space. So that was whizzing around in the fan, and that was going all the time. And this is where the sprayer guy used to have all his gear.
like that, just there. And we've just been dumping stuff here and just chucking stuff away. Oh, look at this. My dad's bike doesn't want it anymore, but I think I might be buying it off him, or taking it home at least. Lovely. Have a listen to this, right? Okay. Oh yeah. Nice. Right, so anyway, going on a little bit, just it's nice to make this last little video. It's been an era, and because obviously I come here every now and then, my dad's been fixing my cars, we sprayed the minibus in this garage too. If you've seen my minibus, my camper conversion, we sprayed it right there. But it's all going, tomorrow it'll be gone. So this is a nice little memorial to not only my dad and all his hard work that he's done, but to the workshop that, you know, has given us a good few years worth of service and got us to where we are now. Right, you don't go from zero to 100, do you, straight away? You've got to work your way up, as we have. And that's it, guys. So, end of an era. What else can I say? This was the place. And I'm going to say goodbye. Take it easy, guys. Ciao for now.